people I call Nigeria Complain came about out of passion to help people to live healthy. As a young child from the village, I've seen elderly people suffered so much health challenges. And my little exposure after my university degree, I discovered that an average young man, after about the age of 35, when he's actually due to settle down to start enjoying life, in most cases, either diagnosed of diabetes, or hypertension, hepatitis, or one chronic ailment or the other, and the rest of their life will be to go to hospitals every now and then, taking drugs, and it's like to them life is not fulfilled. And out of that passion, I said no, something needs to be done. It wasn't by chance, because looking at my pedigree, my father used to practice herbs, and the whole community used to come around, and he treated them for free. And for years, many people survived snake bite, all sorts of things. And so I've brought up seeing the potency of herbs, that this thing is God's provision for man's health. And after much studies also, I discovered that this thing is the alternative to herbs, as far as I'm concerned. And looking at Africa in particular, we have this intimacy with nature over the years, and the only way we can maintain our body is to patronize nature. Presently, we are exploring Moringa oleifera, ginger, commonly that is the common herb around us. They use it for food spices, but the medicinal benefit is much more than the nutritional benefit. Bitter leaf, neem, and many other herbs around us. Yes, we grow them, and some of them are already available in most households, especially in the Southwest. So all we do is to put money in the pocket of those who have it. Look, this thing is not just for ornamental purpose, but we can make money out of it. Moringa in particular has a lot of benefits. It's a plant that from the every part of the plant highly medicinal. For instance, the leaf. Very good as oxidant. It contains about 46 antioxidant properties, and is known from available scientific evidence that Moringa can sustainably address over 200 health challenges, principally immunity. Human immunity is the bedrock of our defense against diseases and sickness. So once your immunity is high, the chance of falling sick is limited. Is low, you are vulnerable to diseases, because your body ability to resist is very weak. And so Moringa contains about 18 amino acids, minerals and vitamins, not just in any proportion, more than the common vegetables and fruits around us. For instance, it contains about 9 times protein in yogurt, about 7 times the vitamin A in carrots. And when you take this, it fortifies the body, it helps the body to fight against virus, bacteria, and germs. Now, apart from that, it contains phytochemical compounds that can address specific health challenges. For instance, hypertension. It also contains phytochemical compounds that can help the body to generate, where beta cells, in the case of insulin, where B cells are down, it helps to repair them. So it's a plant that has the ability. To us, it's like health insurance. That when you take it regularly, it helps to secure your health from anyhow. Let me give you a personal experience. For many years, I suffered frequent malaria, almost every two weeks. In fact, if you trace my medical history, you will see that malaria is common. For more than 5 years, while I was in school, every two weeks, I go to university clinic. I was serving, and I discovered that there should be a solution to this problem. After a series of tests, discovered that there's something I need to address. And that's how one of the things that led me to Moringa, trying Moringa. And since 2006, more than 6 years now, I've not treated malaria. And several persons, friends I know that suffer similar frequent malaria, they've tried it, and that was the end of frequent malaria. So I can imagine how many people have been suffering from this over the years, because their immunity, their body cannot resist stress for a long time. with moringa, you can overcome that. Now, that's just the leaf.
Yes.
The seed, moringa oil is one of the best, finest volatile oil in the world. It contains about 72 oleic acid content, and that makes it a very high moisturizer. Now, moringa oil can be used as cooking oil, and it is the oil that is good for the body. Unlike other oil, it's the fatty acid component is very comfortable for the body to use. It can replace our consumable oil, and the potential there is much. Unlike the other oil, soya beans is quite expensive, but moringa is a tree crop that you can grow for 20 years, you'll be harvesting it, unlike soya beans that you keep growing every year. So definitely the cost of production will come down if government can really create an enabling environment to put out grain moringa and process oil from it as consumable oil. It will increase the shelf, the health status. Diabetic, as we all know, and hypertension is a common problem in our society. And so taking the right oil can go a long way to help us to address this health menace. Presently, there are people who grow it for us as a contract farmer. All we do is to train them. Our farms are organically operated without herbicide, anything that will pollute or diminish the phytochemical content. So they grow it for us, we buy back from them. Some of them are retirees, some of them are clergymen who don't have official work to do, but they can go to farm. So we buy from people that is putting money in their pocket, and then we engage women to process it. And it's very easy for them, you know, to process. All we need to do is to train them. And thereafter, we dry with the best practice available. We package them to the consumable form, especially tea. We have about 12 farm locations. Yes, we have plans to expand. Virtually all our products are registered, except one or two that is pending, that they've not given us approval. There are scientific evidence that support the nutritional value, the medicinal value of this plant. And so it's not a dispute. There's no dispute about the efficacy of herbs worldwide. Yes, we're happy, particularly happy for the minister, because for the first time we are seeing somebody who is from among us. And until you pick the right person, some people are professional farmers in quotes, but they don't know the pain the farmers are passing through. If you have been on the farm, you know the challenge of farmers. And so I'm very confident that the minister is going to address critical issues that affect farmers. There are many issues facing farming, but all we want government to do is to create an enabling environment. Our fathers who brought us up, this is where we met them, and we cannot afford to abandon it. To me, there's no alternative to any nation surviving other than agriculture, because food is basic. We cannot drink fuel. We cannot drink stone. We cannot eat stone, rather, but we eat food. As far as I'm concerned, when God created man, the only thing one needs to survive, apart from the genetic composition, is the environment. And that environment comes from food. And so let the new minister program agriculture. Number one, the rural farmers. What they need to do to encourage the rural farmers. And then the like of agribusiness entities to position them in processing. Integrate them to the rural farmers, where the rural farmers will produce, we buy from them, we process. And then set up enabling marketing environment. One of the major challenges we face is market. The market is not secure, it's so porous. The regulations are so weak, and corruption allow. Imagine, we don't have any business importing vegetable oils into this country, and all sorts of agricultural produce that we can produce. But it's unfortunate that the market is so porous. Let something be done in regulation, especially importation. Once the border is closed, everybody will look inward. Why should somebody invest in filling station instead of investing in his father's farm estate that trained him years ago? Or we have abandoned farm now, it's filling station or that thing. So let the agribusiness, let the marketing environment be created. Once the demand is there, everybody will go back. It will be compelled to start producing. But otherwise, no matter what you do, when there's no market, you'll be frustrated. Yes, agriculture is quite risky, but the risk is associated with our low technical know-how. Because once you know something, there's no uncertainty. You are certain that this will happen. And so number one is to reduce risk. We need to invest on education, to educate farmers what needs to be done. Once they know what to do, the uncertainties will be eliminated to the minimal extent. We know our rainfall pattern is not regular. So instead of, depending on rain and depending on then the insurance, why not invest on irrigation? Portable irrigation for smallholders, farmers. Dig well, provide necessary small irrigation facility that can serve 2 acres. That man, that woman in that village will be contented to grow the vegetable without depending on rain. And the crop will be available at the right time. But when you depend on rain, and like last year, 2015, the rain pattern was not good enough for some of us. It affected most of our crops. At the peak period when you need to apply fertilizer, no rain. And the time rain starts, it's too late. So irrigation, portable ones that can address small older farmers, not necessarily have to go to dam. Not everybody have access to dam, but let everybody in their locality have access to something little they can make use of. Now, if that is settled, of course, it will eliminate this issue of scarcity at the time and then of surplus at the time. The market, will be stable. Our focus, our prayer is that in the next 5 years, instead of the statistics of those who are diabetic, hypertensive going up, we want it down. As of 2014, about 57 million Nigerians are hypertensive, and the statistics has been on the increase. We are presently now collaborating with some universities to develop anti-hypertensive tea that will be very effective, that people can take it and they will address it. Not only that, there are people who are within the vulnerable age bracket, that within the next 3 years, they become hypertensive. What should be done? No drug to prevent. But we are developing a tea that people can take and prevent them from being diabetic, from being hypertensive. And that is our focus. So we are targeting this group of people because it's disturbing that every year people get becoming hypertensive, diabetic, and before you know, heart attack, which is one of the silent killer today. As a result of these things, they get injury, they're not getting cured. In the process, cancer enter, hepatitis enter, and so many other health challenges.
Agribusiness has come to stay. It is high time we keep on applying the concept of agribusiness, as in ensuring that we do agriculture as a business and not as social service as it used to be. And we have been trying to promote that and ensuring that our people, our members, does that. And we are very proud of what Noble Icon, Mr. Patrick Nello, is doing by trying to revolutionize agriculture. And we, on our part, we have a concept, we call it the Gentleman Farmer Scheme, where I am the national coordinator. We try as much as possible to encourage people, enlist elites into agricultural practice. That is, our members who are workers and practitioners of agriculture should have a way of generating extra income apart from fully relying on government in everything when it comes to economic empowerment. And what Patrick Nello is doing, he has really joined our practitioners as a practitioner group, and on his own, we are now working very seriously together to promote what is coming up with the herbal farm. In those days, it used to be going to the farm, the naturality of the farm, going down the bush and getting herbs. But he is now going to full herbal farm, and we are trying to partner with him by listing him in our Basoyin Integrated Farm Estate project. He's going to be having some of the hectares to do his herbal farm. And our organization is proud of to be associated with him in that line. The present government should encourage purposeful young men like Mr. Patrick, the MD of Noble Icon. And also, we have arable lands in Nigeria. We have young, energetic young men in Nigeria. The government should stop funding the destructive sector. They should start funding the productive sector. So you see, they are spending so much money on Niger Delta youth regressiveness, spending money on security. But I want to say that if government funds the productive sectors and people that are really ready to develop Nigeria, Nigeria will be better for it. And now we have the lands everywhere. We are calling on government to bring back the NADA, Nigeria Agric Land Development Authority. They should bring back NADA and ensure that we have a lot of bulldozers to clear lands for young men, so that people can go into farm and do what they should do with farm. But in a situation where farming, to be candid with you, is a very expensive venture, highly, very, very expensive. So I want to say that government must subsidize farming too. As much as they are subsidizing petroleum, they should also subsidize agriculture. And how do they subsidize agriculture? By bringing that back NADA, that is clearing land for people and helping people in the area of cultivation, and ensuring that banks are focused on to ensure that when they are giving loans, they should give loan by single digit loan. I'm even talking about not just single digit, as much as 9%, the one the central bank is talking about now. We are talking about loan of 5% downward. There's nothing wrong in giving such loan, because apart from the monetary gain, the social advantage in giving such loan to Nigeria is enormous. And the government should also, as much as possible, recognize young men that are working like this and give them the financial impetus for them to be able to turn the nation around. You can see, if you come into this company, you see the number of people that this young man has been able to employ. And even in our little farming activities, if you see the number of people we have been able to encourage and empower in our own little way without government assistance. So we have Nigerians that are ready to put in their best to Nigeria, but government should ensure that. Another very pertinent thing in agriculture is security. I remember I've lost over 2 million naira in my small safe to agriculture, where Fulani herdsmen will just come and eat up all your farm. And it is high time the government incorporate the Fulani people as an integral part of agriculture. Let them know that they are part of agriculture. They should not see themselves as different from agriculture. So by the time you integrate them and make them to feel like farmers or agriculturists, they will appreciate it and now begin to treat fellow agriculturists as important. And that for now, that is what I think government should do.
Okay, we are the growers of Moringa. At the same time, we are also into the export. Noble does more of the processing and standardization of Moringa. But we plant, and as well we buy to also export. The potential of Moringa is huge. We've been able to take it to a lot of continents. We've sent the tea to Australia. The response has been good. I'm based in South Africa and the response is good. America and so on and so forth. We see so much. I've done quite a lot of farming. I've done maize, soya beans, vegetables, and I've come to realize that Moringa is just like the name, the miracle tree, is the crude oil tree. And I see so much potential in it. Right now that the country is looking into diversifying, where crude oil is coming down, I think Moringa would possibly be the solution, because you can process it into so many things. the herbal importance of it, I mean, we can talk about it for the whole day. And the fact that it grows easily, and there's so much potential in it. And this year we're planning to raise 30,000 seedlings to expand. That's the only thing we are planting now, and we believe we can push it, especially now that Naira is falling so badly. Every focus should be on export, and one of the easiest things that we can process to export, I think it's moringa.